Our speaker this evening, ladies and gentlemen, is Alfred Orda. He was for many years a singer at the Settlers' Wells Opera and sang in many other places as well, a baritone whom many of you saw on stage. He has been to many meetings of this society. You will have seen him, and many of you have spoken to him. We have, as you know, CDs of him. One came out some time ago of songs, and this one is purely of opera, including an aria from Conrad Wallenrode. Now, don't say you've all got 17 different versions of that, because it's a very rare aria. It's a very good aria as well. Anyway, we're having a different way of doing it today. Alfred will be questioned. I think that's a good word, is it? Questioned? Interrogated?
It's hard.
Prompted.
He will join in conversation with Paul Lewis, and will give some details about technical department pass, about his career, which, I say, well, if you buy the CD, you'll hear what the voice was, and it's a very good voice. But, ladies and gentlemen, Alfred Orda.
Mr. Orda, in a lifetime of singing, you must have heard and met many great singers. Perhaps you could tell us, who was the first great singer you heard?
Mattia Battistini.
Where was that?
In Lodz, in 1926.
Not before. How old were you?
I was about past eight.
So 1924, 1923.
Yeah.
And what do you remember of hearing Battistini?
I have heard singing him first. It came to my mind this beautiful singing of his Ambonati in Questa Valle. Mm. And then he sang Caccini's
Vittoria,
and then a song by Rotoli, La Sposa Sarà la Mia Bandiera. And I remember when he came on the stage, looked very old, you know, and I asked myself how that man could finish this aria so slow. I mean, but when he started to sing, my fright gone. I started to think what a marvelous sound was coming from this old gentleman. And after, when he finished first part of his concert, a little girl in white came on the stage with rose. One was a red one, and he was rushing to her, took her in his hand, kissed her the brow, and asked for a chair to bring, and he put her near her to sit. And he was singing with her on which she was sitting, and he was singing, finished the program. And everybody was so delighted. And I remember this when he came, in those days he wore white gloves and spats white, you know, and looks like an emperor penguin. And when he bent to kiss her, almost you could hear cracking of starch on his shirt. But it was so sweet. I remember after the interval, people wanted to go to his to see him, and an agent doesn't allow to come only after the performance. That's and of course always this. And I remember my mother used to have this program, old one. You see, so that Rotoli aria lingered so much in my mind that later, when I had a voice already established, I sang this aria, which you have seen, even I have in this program, in when I was in Rome, I repeated in this with Cotoni.
So let's hear Mattia Battistini, who was born in 1856, Let's hear him sing Ambonati in questa valle from Lindo di Chamonix. Hometown of Lodz was...
I wanted to tell you this, that when I arrived to this country after France collapsed, I lost all my music. And then I was building up again my repertory, and I went to Augner's looking through editions of opera arias, and I found the aria from Favorita, you know, the famous Atanto Amor, and it was written, English edition, Agnes, written, included in program by Battistini in 1924.
At the Queen's Hall.
Queen's Hall.
Yes.
And that's, I remember that the year before he was in Poland, something like that. That was his last visit to Eastern Europe. After that, he was very ill, as I understand. And I have still musical edition of Polish magazine Monthly Musica, which says 1928, it said the bells rang farewell for Battistini. He died in May, something like that. I'll bring you someone here.
Now, in Lodz, which was a center of musical life, you heard many other fine singers. I think you told me that you heard some of the famous cantors in concert.
Moisse Koussevitzki and Sirota.
Yes.
Sirota was about 60 years of as a cantor. He was a jubilee, some kind of. I remember I and my friend, we couldn't get tickets, so we went from the behind of the Philharmonia and tried to go to the steps that they never used. I'm climbing over the window so to hear him.
What did Sirota sing?
He sang some first half of the concert. It was Saturday evening, Jewish melodies, you know, in the regalia. And then after second half, he sang it in the evening dress, but I sang some kind of arias like this, which I don't remember very well now.
And Koussevitzki's concert was
Koussevitzki, Koussevitzki was frequent. Koussevitzki I have had in 1933 a few times in Lodz and then in Helenov Park in May. You know, it was on open air. So many people thought he sang very beautiful arias.
Alan has brought along a record of his. Would you like to say what it is?
You'll have to excuse me for a few moments because it does take a little exposition. The Koussevitzki record I'm loaned Alfred to play this evening is not liturgical. It is a folk song sung in Yiddish. But I don't know if you know, but Jewish humour is very self-deprecatory. And they're always making fun of themselves. And in this particular instance, in the same way that like George Bernard Shaw said, the tenor is not a man, he is a disease. And all tenors, because of singing high notes, are stupid. In Jewish folklore, the cantor, the Yiddish word is chazan, or the Hebrew word, and the word for an idiot is a nar. And the Jews say a chazan is a nar, a cantor is a fool. For the same reason, he is vain, and it's probably the high notes that he sings in synagogue that addle his brains. Well, this is a story of a cantor who meets his own president, or the lay leader of the community, in the street. Now, normally the cantor stands on a raised dais and prays on behalf of the synagogue, and sitting in front of him, looking towards the ark, are the members of the board. So they would never look behind to see who's actually singing. That's obviously not true, but this is the basis of the story. And the cantor walks up to the president of his synagogue and says, in a very, very cantorial way, just like a tenor might say, do you know I'm a tenor? So this cantor says, do you know who I am? And the president says, no, I don't know who you are. He says, surely you know who I am. Oh yes, the president says, you're the chap who deals in feathers. Feathers, he said, my grandmother didn't even have the luck to sleep on feathers. What have I got to do with feathers? He says, oh, no, you're not the chap that sells feathers, you're the chap that sells leather. And so on, and the cantor, in exasperation, exhibits more of his cantorial art in order to demonstrate who he is. And finally, the president says, oh, yes, I know who you are, of course. You're our cantor, and you're also a bit of a fool. And the cantor says, well, a cantor I am, but a fool I'm not. Moisse Koussevitzki, the cantor and the president.
toget mir asher yosare sodom bi chokhmo un azir hevi zogich mir asher yosare sodom bi chokhmo etel wer sein dir ihre bi Sein, dach sag mir Avrom ich dem Scheche zanei dim, was handelt mit Leder. Oi, 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 meine Seide, und die gehandelt mit kein Leder. Oh, mein Gott, hat Avad, denn ihr gehandelt mit kein Leder, was soll ich zu tun mit Leder? Ihre Bier, Ihre Bier. Weißt ihr, der Scheune, wer ihr sein, dachte ich mir, Avrom Bersan, Neidin, was handelt mit Federn. Ai, 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 meine Seide hat nicht gehandelt mit kein Federn, und meine Bube ist ab viele nicht geschlafen mit kein Federn, was hab ich zu tun mit Federn? Ich bin, jetzt weißt ihr schon, wer ihr bin. Weiß ich schön, wer ihr sein. Ihr sein, dach sag mir ein bisschen ja Hasen. Oh, ja, ein bisschen Anna. Ai, 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 und ein bisschen gar nicht. Ach, Hasen, bin ich doch ja.
Say that in those days I've been told, talking among community Jewish over then, that he commanded in those days, 1933, when kilogram of best beef cost 75 gross in Poland, you know, zloty, 75 gross. He commanded 5,000 zlotys for a night in synagogue. In those days. And also, in America, when I was, they told me that this voice saved him when he was in Auschwitz.
He was one of four brothers, all of them.
In Warsaw, in your late teens, you started your musical studies,
yes.
And of course you met most of the leading singers of the time.
Yeah.
You told me that you were a personal friend of the two great sopranos of the day, Adasari and Eva Bandrowska.
Yes. Well, Adasari, I have met later in my life, already personally. She was even our guest in our house here in London when she
She sang with Toscanini in
yes, yes, oh yes, she was one of our greatest sopranos, and also Bandrowska-Turska I have met in 1935, a year before I went to Italy, in the conservatorium. She sang this Roxanne aria and this Szymanowski recital.
We've got a recording of.
And
of
here I sang, I sang here in London, in Parcel Hall a few years ago, arranged concert by Polish community.
Yes.
I took part with her on the concert.
Here's Eva Bandrowska-Turska singing Queen Roxanne's aria from King Roger by Szymanowski.